I love you,
So what should we do on Laylatul Qadr? What are the main things to be done? Obviously, the greatest act of worship on Laylatul Qadr is the Salah. And that is why we pray extra on Laylatul Qadr. And that is because Salah combines between all of the ibadat. Salah has ruku', Salah has sajda, Salah has tilawa of the Quran, Salah has dhikr, Salah has dua. And especially on Laylatul Qadr, we should elongate our qiyam. We will be doing qiyams as well here in the masjid, and you're free to come here. And if you're able to pray at home as well, pray at home. And if you're able to do more khushu' at home, do more khushu' at home. Between home and the masjid, you choose the one where your khushu' is more. For some people, they can attain better tranquility at home when they're alone. And for others, they need to hear the Quran and be in the ambience, whichever one works for you. Whether you do it private or whether you do it in public, the goal is that your khushu' is there. And even if you come to the masjid will be our taraweeh, and then we'll have qiyam at night, and there's plenty of other hours as well. So the number one deed that should be done is that of salah. And in the salah, we should elongate the sajda and the ruku', and we should recite much Quran. So this salah is a long salah. And in the sajda, we increase our du'as. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from sincerity, from our hearts. We ask Allah, begging Allah azza wa jal, knowing He can hear us, knowing only He can give us what we want. We open our hearts to Allah and have a direct conversation in a secret voice and a small whispering, and Allah hears that whispering. We should have ilm al-yaqeen that Allah is hearing and seeing, and Allah can give us what we want. So the number one action is that of salah. Number two, that also between the salahs that we do, because we cannot just pray all 8 hours or 7 hours, between the salah we do dhikr, the tasbih and the takbir and the tahmeed, and we say istighfar, and we say the famous dua that our Prophet ﷺ taught Aisha, Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anna. This is a powerful dua, because afu means to erase all of our sins. It is actually more powerful than maghfirah. Maghfirah is also powerful, but it means to cover the sins. Afu means it's as if it never existed. So afu, to wipe the paper clean. There's no trace left. There's no markings. It's as if we never did the sin. So we want this Ramadan to wipe our sins clean as if we never did them. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anna. That's the dua that we make. As well, on this night, we should do any good deed, especially feeding the hungry and giving charity. So from now, before those nights begin, earmark, where am I going to give my charity? Look at the charities you want. And then on those nights, if you can physically go and give, or these days online if you can give, but know the charities you're going to give to, and then give something every single one of those nights. Can you imagine a charity that will give you the reward of 1,000 months of continuous charity? So give charity on this night. As well, on this night, of the deeds that are good to do, and not a lot of people think about them, is the cleansing of the heart, internal. Look at your own heart. What diseases are there? Jealousy, hatred. Do you have something in your heart against somebody? Cleanse it. Make it a pure heart. Make it qalb saleem. You be pure, and Allah Azza wa Jal will bless you.